Grace Chatting here, founder of Relationship Academy, where we teach lessons that they didn't teach at school. I'd like you to just take a moment to think about, how does it feel when you feel deeply understood by someone? For me, I tend to relax, I feel connected, I soften, I'm more inclined to hear what they're saying because I'm feeling, ah, he gets me or she gets me. You know that feeling when you feel they get you? It's a good feeling, and it's good for couples to get used to generating that feeling for each other. So it's a natural outcome from being totally present and listening. So far in this little video series communication for couples, we've looked at intention, we've looked at listening, and now we're talking about understanding. But look, this isn't just about words, as I hope you've picked up from the last video. This is about the magic between two people. This is about the connection between two people. This is about connecting in a way that there is an intimacy and a knowing each other and, you know, getting each other. So, you know, that feeling that you long for, we all love to be understood. And actually, one of the most frustrating things is when you feel misunderstood. We all know what that feels like. So one of the ways that we can engender that feeling in our partner that we are understanding, and actually that we do understand them, is not thinking about what you're going to say, totally focused and attuned. Attuned is something that is a relationship skill. To be attuned to your partner, attuned to yourself, and attuned to them. You might want to do a Google search on and elaborate on attunement. Often, as I said in my last video, we haven't experienced being attuned to as children. It's a developmental gap that we have, but it's good for us to get used to tuning to ourselves. What do I need? What do I want? How do I communicate this to my partner? What does my partner need? What does my partner want? And how can I tune into that? Even, you know, if we're not skilled yet with the words. So one of the other ways of developing that deep understanding, which is an aspect of deep listening, is having an open mind about where they're coming from, not judging, not mistrusting, but staying open-minded and not prejudging where they're coming from. So open mind, open heart, open will, just staying in a state of openness to just hear without jumping to conclusions where they're at and what's going on. And another thing, a way of deepening the understanding, is to be curious. Be curious about what is my partner really telling me here beyond the words that they're using. So it's that curiosity, you know, from a neuroscience point of view, curiosity is something that comes from the right hemisphere. Thinking comes from our left hemisphere. And when we're thinking, generally speaking, we will only ever come up with something that we knew previously. When we wonder about something, something can occur to us that we'd never even thought of before, that never occurred to us because it's not being part of our historical thinking or conditioning. So when you're listening deeply to your partner, just allow yourself to be curious and I wonder what he or she is trying to communicate to me, and stay in that state of open mind, open heart, open will. So I'll follow up on how do we hone this skill even more, the skill of connecting, listening, hearing, understanding, and I'll say some more in the next video. Bye for now.